Hello friends, I'm Dr. Devesh and we are from Team Prime and we are very honored today with two of the AIIMS toppers, Dr. Ajay rank 42 and Dr. Utpal rank 71. So congratulations to both of you for such a great feat, and we all want guidance from you. How you people have prepared and what was your strategy? Since the joining of MBBS, when you started feeling ki we should start preparing for AIIMS exam, and what you did, how you have gone for preparation, you based on textbook and how you have amalgamated textbook with guidebooks or your notes, what you have done, when you started? Ajay?
I started in sir, third year, sir. So mainly textbook was the main focus which we were preparing from for profs and all. So with that base, and during the exam time the guidebooks are important, and in some of the things like anatomy, so the classes by Dr. Rajesh Koshal were helpful, and in and the other books like in pathology, your book I read, so that was great.
So what do you want to say about textbook you read in second year?
Yes, standard textbooks are a must. I mean to say, we need to focus more on those standard textbooks during your profs. I mean, you don't need to touch the MCQ books until you are finished with the third prof. According to me, that's what I want to say. You need a proper base before you touch the MCQ books, because they don't provide you with the concepts. The concepts are built upon the standard textbooks, and the MCQ base should be done after that.
That's actually, even I feel like that, ki it's a great opinion. Ki one should start with textbook, because textbook you will build your concept and you will connect your other future questions, future subjects like surgery, medicine or clinical subjects. So that will be good for long term. We are not living here only for cracking postgraduate exam. We have to become good physician also.
One thing I want to say, sir, that you enjoy reading textbooks, that is important. So because like guidebooks are not enjoying, that is like a preparation for examination rather than. But if you enjoy your subject and that kind of passion for medicine, that can only come through the textbooks, the standard textbooks.
It's very concrete point you are telling. Unless you don't go into the depth of the subject, you don't enjoy. Passion will not come out automatically. You have to enjoy those things, and for enjoying those things, you have to have depth of the knowledge, which will come only with the textbook, right? So it's very good thing, you have to go through the textbook. So you 4.5 years you prepared with your textbooks side by side. You might be solving some MCQ and something like that. And when 1 year was there, then you took the shortcut of guidebook because time was little less, right? Like that you did.
Yeah, we did that way.
I think if you are going through textbook, then you don't need to plan for as such PG examination, because you are doing your MBBS thoroughly and genuinely with heart. And so whenever then there is time of exam, you can go to guidebooks and if needed coaching materials and other classes. But textbook are must. That is what I mean.
So what do you say?
I want to say ki exams like AIIMS, they focus on things which are not like you mugged up the thing and that's going to ask directly. I mean, they always twist the question and give options which are difficult to interpret, and unless you read the textbook properly. I mean, then only you get the confidence of choosing or ruling out options of the four.
That's a great thing. If you are conceptually good, then only you can eliminate two options or three options or something like that. Otherwise, you won't be able. It's not a trick you learn in a coaching center or within a year you will learn. It's knowledge only which will help you to rule out all these options, right? So tell me, how you have approached. See, what I understood, or what our audience is understanding, that through 4.5 years, basically your methodology was based on the textbook and your own notes, what you are preparing side by side. But in those 1 year, when you are preparing for this AIIMS exam, 1 year before while doing internship, what was your strategy? So how you have gone through?
Till we finished the third prof, we never thought about giving PG exams. Okay. Our main focus was to study those books and clear our exams, third prof. And based on that knowledge, then we selected particular subjects and bought the MCQ books and started slowly. I mean, internships can be hectic, you can't study and attend the classes and rounds and all everything. But whatever we could do, we did in that whole year, and side by side. We couldn't prepare everything. That depends on which posting which you have earlier and later on. But my main focus was to get as much as possible during that duration.
So you tell me, Ajay, you how you know that ki these are the topics which examiner is going to ask in our AIIMS exam? Means how you come to know, by solving MCQ book or by some seniors?
Yes sir, like seniors help was very important, and you have to also see previous examination papers, like whichever exam you are interested in. Let's say if you are interested in AIIMS, you have to see the AIIMS examination papers, then you have to see what kind of questions are being asked and what subjects are more important. So that way you have to prepare. So I planned like an internship, I planned a schedule for like 6 months, in that every subject was given that weightage according to the size of the subject and the importance of the subject in the examination. And like the, and which also included like the, there are some subjects like microbiology, pathology, where images were to be seen. So mostly like if you read through images, or let's say from USMLE first aid, so that preparation gets easier and you don't have to mug up much. So, and the subject gets completed earlier.
So you both are telling the same thing. Means ki you, what you are telling ki overall this 4.5 year, which year is more important to focus upon to get more concept and to get a good rank in AIIMS exam?
I think
second and third year. I'm interested. First year maybe we are newcomers, we are just learning new things. I don't mind that, and we never studied, we never took first year as seriously. But second and third year are subjects which are scoring for every PG exam. I mean, if those things are thorough, you can easily get a good rank, not the best rank, but these things are the base which provide you with a reasonably good rank. I mean, and you can focus more on other subjects later on if second and third year is good.
Ajay, what do you say?
I think first year and second year are important. Yeah. Like, so if you want to prepare, like you don't have to take stress about PG as such, but like the subject preparation has to be started from second year. And like, because like if you have good base in anatomy or physiology, you will do good in the final year subjects. Yeah. So you don't have to mug up again, right? So that is important. So like the preparation of examination can be started in final year or internship or whenever you feel like, but for making concepts or to become like good doctor, that part I think from first year you should focus.
Yeah, what you are actually telling, what I want to say to the all aspirants, PG aspirants, that ki first year and second year subjects are very important, not only for the PGME preparation, for the future clinical practices also, because anatomy, physio, biochemistry, patho, micro, all these are base of the surgery, medicine, ortho, all these subjects.
You study for first 3 years and you just never touch those books. You know, so you are never well versed with those subjects. You just keep on reading third prof.
That's what I found, that many of the toppers, they say that ki first year, second year subjects are very, very important. As you were telling also same thing, ki first year, second year subject you read very well, right?
And in final year, you are like, in final year knowledge is fresh, you know things and you go to wards and you know things. So those questions are easier. But if you do not have not read like the first year and second year subjects, the average questions of those subjects become tough in that, because you do not, let's say, if you plan for like 6 months or 9 months strategy, so like you will go get only 10 days for preparing for anatomy, or let's say 15 days for pathology, or 20 days for pharmacology. So even the basic questions which you did well in professional examination, that gets tough during the examination. So I think the revision of the first and second year should be done thoroughly.
So what do you say about revision? How you people used to revise from the second year itself? You were revising, or you started revising only when it was 1 year?
We actually used to revise, I mean revise during the prof examination, professional examinations. But for PG oriented, if you want to ask sir, we used to decide first of all how much time we have before the exam, and divide the time accordingly and study as much as possible. I mean, don't overread the subject. I mean, you do give a particular time. If it's left behind something, you leave it, start the next subject, because you need to have some knowledge of each and every subject, because every question is going to be asked from each subject.
That's a great actually, that's a great strategy. What do you say, Ajay?
Yeah, that is important, sir. And we have to also see through like help of our teacher or senior that we do not have to overread or repeat because we are short of time. So let's say there is hepatitis, we will also be reading for microbiology, medicine and pathology. So choose a subject where it is given in like good manner and the questions can be solved. So leave that in the other subject, in the same way, let's say HIV,
common things.
So the most of the medicine things will be covered in pathology, pharmacology, and microbiology. So in that way, it can be done. So you do not have to then again read like textbook for medicine, I guess.
Yeah, means you need to have a proper plan. Okay? These are the topics I will read from here. These are the topics I will read from here. These are the topics I will read from here.
You start from first, second, prof.
Yeah.
And then even if
then you only you can. Yeah.
Even if you don't have time for majors.
Yeah.
Better you revise first, second, prof again because those are the scoring subjects.
Yeah. Those are the scoring and you and the actually very good base of you. Mm-hmm. You are getting very good base from these smaller subjects as you can say means compared to the medicine or surgery which is limitless. You can go along with that. So I want to ask you one thing. What is the role of internet or Facebook or WhatsApp in your preparation? Did you follow some group or WhatsApp group? Means, do you feel ki it should be used? It should be absolutely used. It is absolutely contraindicated, or it should be a balanced act. Means, if something is very good, some forum or some group is good, you are taking assistance. And some WhatsApp group is very good, you are taking assistance. As I heard that some of the things are... So what you did, means what's your, both of you, what do you have opinion about this thing?
I think like when you are having free time, having lunch or something that, then you can go through the Facebook groups or WhatsApp because that keeps you somewhat boosted up that people are doing this thing. So that kind of competitiveness should be there. Another thing is ki if there is a doubt or your teacher is updating like about new updates, then you have to know about that. So the only method is internet, I guess. And there are like on internet, you can also use like if you have access to up to date, then there will be some doubts, some questions which you will not be able to solve on your own or from textbook. Then and let's say new guidelines, then you can go for up to date or even you can download new guidelines asking from your teacher or seniors. So that's a great idea, but
did you took any help, Utpal?
Yeah, we took. I mean, for me, it was like ki the subject which was difficult for me, I used to take help of those subjects online.
Yeah.
I mean, they used to be well versed. They used to get revised every day. So I used to the things which I didn't like or some subjects which I didn't like to study. I mean, it's better if somebody just tells me on the phone those things which I would avoid reading it on my own. I mean, those subjects would be better off if you use it on the net. But otherwise, I would say you don't overuse the internet.
Yeah, you just said we don't overuse. Actually, that is the point I want to understand, or our PG aspirant should understand. We should not be always on the Facebook or always on the WhatsApp. You are coming for a fraction of time in a day, and you are just watching, and then you are going away from them, taking after all those.
That internet thing is out of your study hours. In study hours, you cannot include internet thing because. For that, you have to read the books or the notes, whatever.
And because it's very good also. Now what you are saying in during study hours, if you are open your WhatsApp, every time it will be beeping and you will be getting disturbed. Focus will not be there. So it should be restricted. It's not absolute contraindication as many people they are telling
all
right
the
now.
All the major updates, I would say, are taken from the net only. You can't get all major updates.
Yeah.
You won't know if a new update is coming. That's the best possible.
For updates, it's good, but for asking some doubts and all, I think it's a bad idea to go to internet
because
if you will post today, you will get the answer tomorrow or that answer
might not be correct also.
So you have to go to textbook or other reliable sources rather than going to internet for updates which your teachers are posting. For that, internet is great idea.
The things which are posted by the teachers, just look at those things. Don't look at the questions which are posted by others. I mean, there can be relevance, I don't not say that.
Like internet has a lot of distractions there.
Yeah, that's very true. That's what I want to say nowadays also to all the PG aspirants. Come for half an hour in a day, just take all the information, whatever is new, and you just go back, you sit back, you study well, don't indulge much into it. But it's necessary. What I want to say that, because it's an advanced era and here we can use, but it should not be over-indulged, as you said, and it should not be overused, and it should be proper utilization should be there. So tell me, what you both did in last 3 years, last 3 months before exam? What was your planning? How you revised? How much time you have given to MCQ? How much time you have given to the theory part?
Yes, sir. Like in the last 3 months, the main focus is on revising what you have already read. So main message to be given is like that time, just one thing is eat well, sleep well. Take care of yourself because that time I have seen people that at the last time they lose hope. So that's what like the so the revision should be a good strategy, and like all the subjects should be covered. So and the last year's question papers, like last some year's question papers, should be done, because in every exam there are repeats. So
even if you don't get repeat questions, you get the idea about time management and how many questions you are getting negative. I mean, you can correct or you reduce your negative marking by solving these papers.
Okay.
You can come to know that these questions could be
means you come to know that these are high yielding topics also, which we should focus on. Even that topic will be repeated, but MCQ will be new. Like that, we have to identify what are the important topics.
And if time permits, then you should do a good test series also. That gives you an idea about the paper, gives you an idea about time management, and gives you a bit competitive kind of.
Gives you confidence that the thing which I study right now, I am able to solve the paper.
At least you get practice, and that is very important.
Very important.
Only reading theory or MCQ solving, you must attend one test series also, so that you should know that.
And that also helps us, like which subject is weak or which topic is weak, so which you have to focus more on, so that way.
That way you don't feel anything different. I mean, you're just sitting at home. You feel like you're just sitting home giving another exam. So that's an added.
And what was your strategy for image-based question? What you did actually? Did you follow standard books images, or you clubbed this with images which is present on internet also via Google and all in between?
For some standard textbooks like pathology and all, we used to follow those textbooks for image, since the amount of questions being asked in AIIMS has been increasing.
Yeah.
Considering image based questions. So for standard books, standard subjects, we used to use the books. For others, we just used to Google the images for whatever we used to think that this could be asked, this particular instrument or whatever image this could have been asked. So even the AIIMS people, they just select any standard image from the Google only.
Yeah.
So, I mean, if you are well versed with that, you just look at that image before going on to the next topic. And I think that will be an easier way.
And what about you, Ajay? What you did?
And then, you have to see the previous paper again, like, even when images were not asked. So, there were some topics which are favorite for examiners. So, mostly images are being asked from them. So, the major topics which you know are important in the subject, the images related to them has to be done. Let's say in pathology, rheumatic heart disease and its valvular lesions needs to be focused on.
Yeah.
Or let's say the changes in MI, so that is important part. Or let's say Barrett's esophagus, so that will be the image which is anyway an important question, and the image will be asked. Like, so mostly the images will not be rare.
Means so, you want to say that images usually they are taking from the older questions which were actually which were MCQ. Now they are taking those topics and their related images they are
the
asking.
Topics are same, but the pattern is changed.
Yeah.
So like you will not be asked very rare images.
Yeah.
That's
means
what, like,
what you want, you're telling what I'm feeling you want to convey this message key. Need not to worry excessively for the images. They are not asking any high thing. They are asking from the books only, and to identify
the basic topics which you already know and well.
Plus, they are giving you the answer in the options.
Yeah.
You can always see the answer. If you look at the image, you might be confused. But if you look at the options, you can easily identify.
Yeah, you can easily identify.
And generally, sir, in AIIMS examination, along with image, they also give the background question, like
history.
The word of the history.
Yeah.
So that also gives a lot of ideas. So I think there should not be much worry about image part.
So and tell me what you did in your exam when you were writing your exam. So how many questions you have attempted, you both, Ajay?
Sir, in examination you have to, I think I attended 195 questions, and as far as I think that you have to attend the maximum questions as much possible. So because if you are confident about 150 questions and which you think are right, and you are leaving 50 questions, then you are out of the race.
And
completely.
What
so
about you, Utpal? How many you attempted?
191 questions I attempted. Attempt ratio should be high. I mean, I would say 170 is par amount of questions which must be attempted if you want a good rank.
Yeah.
Above that, it's an individual risk for you. I mean, if you want, you can take that risk, but there will be a chance of negative marking.
Yeah.
But I would say that you should be confident enough to solve at least 170.
Yeah, actually, even I felt 190, because most of the topper they say 190 plus is always safe, because many of the question nobody knows what is the answer.
You're taking
what they are thinking. Yeah.
So, one thing I want to add is that, like, for attending more questions and avoiding negative marking, there will be some questions which you do not know much, but the, if you read the options, there will be, after ruling out, you will be able to solve them.
Yeah.
So, the thing is ki, at the face value of the question, do not get frightened. Just read the questions and options thoroughly, and there will be a lot of questions which you will be able to answer.
Yeah. So, you want to say that ki, in your exam, many of the questions you have solved where you have ruled out two options, right? And definitely, for ruling out two options, you have to have a very thorough knowledge and very thorough concept during your MBBS also. So what I want to ask you, so you ruled out two options, then you attempted, or you ruled out one option also, then you attempted some question like that?
No sir, it's risky, but if you are able to rule out only one option.
You can take the chance.
Did you take that chance?
You can take a chance only after you have ruled out two options. I didn't take a chance if there was
one option.
I always did that. I mean, okay. If there, I wasn't sure about two options, then I didn't attempt.
Okay. So it means you
will always be intelligent guess rather than wildly sure.
Right.
If you have no knowledge about the question, better to leave it. I mean, it's always going to be negative for you.
Okay. So just tell me one more thing. Ki when you are going through exams, suppose back to back, you might have seen some back to back question which were very difficult to you, or you are ruling out two options. Suppose first question rule out two options, and again remaining two options you are taking the right answer. Second question is also similar. Third question. So back to back 3-4 question is going like this. Some students, they get frightened ki whether I am doing right, my knowledge is adequate. So in those situations, what one should do? Yeah, what should be strategy?
It's like randomized. The questions are randomized for each and every person.
Yeah.
Sometimes the person might get easy questions.
Yeah, that's what.
For me, it was the same which you said, sir. Uh-huh. Initial questions were really tough for me.
Uh-huh.
So my strategy from the beginning has been to always first do the paper quickly in the first round. I mean, do the things which are absolutely sure. Even if you can score only 50% in your first round, that's fine. But you leave out any doubt you have, just leave that question in the first round. And you come back to that after that, because they are going to be tough questions, that's definitely. But you are going to score at least 50% of the questions will be easy, you will be able to solve. So that's important that you solve that in minimum amount of time, so that you can give more time to the difficult questions. So that would be an advice, to solve quickly the questions which are easy, so they can give more time to tough questions.
And the test will always be like this, even for avoiding that kind of self-doubt when the tough questions come at once, so we have to prepare beforehand by giving enough number of tests. I guess that is it.
So here I want to ask you one more thing, because many of the students, they ask ki, sir, I have read well, I have prepared well, and still I am committing silly mistakes during exam. So how you people cope up with the silly mistake? How you have minimized? Definitely there will be some silly mistake, but definitely you are committing less silly mistake. So how you are avoiding all those silly mistakes, what you did?
Again sir, the practice is what, like practicing the tests will avoid the silly mistakes. So, and you cannot avoid all the silly mistakes, so not much worry, but keep practicing. Yeah. That is what I think.
You, only when you solve those papers, then you will read the question properly. Otherwise you will just look
read the question properly. Means what? You are reading question very attentively.
Yeah.
At least reading all options very attentively.
At least once.
Yeah.
I want to say in that part that you do not have much time, and you have to read the questions. So you have to read the questions only once.
Yeah.
And you have to get it like thoroughly. So make that practice that you get it the fully. Like you read it thoroughly and you then go to the options.
Means if you don't know the answer of that question, you should read it properly, so that next time you don't have to read the question, you just have to look at the option. You should know the question in the back of your mind.
So what these people are telling ki in exam, we can cut down the silly mistake by reading question very properly and very thoroughly. Even in one go, we have to read very properly, very intensely. And this is only possible when you will do the practice.
Practice, because that time you have to be cool about. And you have to give it in a bit relaxed manner, rather than if you are in a panic situation, then you will not be able to read properly. You will leave the questions or wherever, like the accept kind of question are there, so you will not realize whether they are asking what is true or what is not true. So that is big silly mistake.
Thank you so much to both of you for coming and enlightening all of us with your preparation strategy. And our team Prime is wishing best wishes to both of you for great and grand success in your every exam of your life. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. We are very thankful.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.